Good evening to one and all present here. Today we are going to see a little bit continuation about the continue and break statement and functions and file input output we are going to see today. From yesterday's session, so many of them asked about the break and continue in little bit more detail. So I have taken small program which will have the break statement and which will have the continue statement. Same statement I have taken, same program I have taken, and I will just execute and show you how this break statement will work and how this continue statement will work. So see this example program. I have taken a for loop I in x range 10. So this will be printing the values from 1 to 10 as a list. Inside the for loop, I have given one indentation if I equal to 5. After that, I have given break. Inside if, I have given print I. So this, what this break will do? Inside the if statement, when you are getting I is equal to 5, when this condition is true, it will break the condition and it will come out of this condition. So after 5, you will not get any values of the range 10. Means you have to, for x range, there is a list of values from 1 to 10, but you will be getting output till 5 only. So I will execute and show the output, then you will understand the use of break. Demo night. See the output. It is printing from 0 to 4. So when this break statement is given, it will be just directly coming out of that condition and it will stop the iteration after I is equal to, when it is getting I is equal to 5, it will stop the iteration over here only. And also you can write it, if it is a single statement, you can write it in a single line. You no need to write it in a new line. If you are going for a multiple statements, then you have to give the indentation. Next we will see continue. For the same program, we are going to see the difference between the break and continue. Same program, instead of break, I have used to continue. What this continue will do? When this if condition I equal to 5, when this condition is true, if it comes to continue statement, it will stop the iteration of I equal to 5 only, and it will come out of the loop and it again it will go for the loop and it will execute from 6, 7, 8 until 10 it will execute, because this continue statement will continue the iteration. It will not stop or it will not come out of the condition. This is the difference between continue and break. So this continue will continue the iteration. It will not stop. It will just skip the iteration of the condition when if I equal to 5. So it will be skipping the iteration of I equal to 5. So after that, whatever statement you are giving inside the condition, those statement also will be skipped. Practically where it will be used, I will be telling one example. In a company, suppose you want to give bonus for the people, whoever is under the attendance of 28 days. If you want to just select only those people, then you can give the condition like this. So they will be just counting that people, and once for that person only, they will not get the bonus. Rest of the person have to get the bonus. In that condition, you can give like this. That continue statement will be used over there. So output, I will show you by running this. You can see the output. It is started to print from 0 to 9 and it has skipped only the number of 5, because this continue statement will stop the iteration of 5 only. When that condition is getting true, only for that particular condition, it will skip the iteration. It will skip means under that if condition, whatever statements are there, all those will be skipped for that time only. Then after that, again, it will continue the iteration. After 5, it will continue from 6 to 10. That's why you are getting 5 is just not printed, rest of that are printed. So break means it will just come out of that condition or loop. It will totally come out and it will stop the iteration over there only. But continue means it will just continue it. That is the difference. Next, we will go for the function. You can ask why we have to go for the function. What is the use of the function? Till yesterday, we are using so many functions. Like to delete element, to insert element, we have used append function. And we have used add function. There are so many functions we have used so far. But this is a predefined function which has been given by somebody to Python. Like that, we also can use, we also can create a function. Excuse me. So now we are going to create our own functions. Here I have given one example. To create your own function, you have to start with def. Def is defining. We are defining one function. You can give your function name whatever you want. I have started with say hello. It is one function name. You have to write what, if you are writing in capital letter, then you have to follow that. Inside the function, this is a function, so we are writing with the colon. Inside that, I am just following, giving indentation. Inside it, whatever you want to write, you can give. For example, just I have given print hello world inside it. It is a block of function inside the say hello. Just I have given only one statement. You can write multiple statement, whatever you want. You can write any program inside it. So if you write one function, wherever you want that function, you can call it. Whenever you need it, you can just call that function. This is the use of the function. You no need to write the program again and again. You can call that function. So I have written, I have defined say hello function. If I want to print that hello world, then I can call whenever I want. I no need to write print hello world like that. For example, I have given only one statement. But whereas if you are going for a practical application, if you want some 100 line program so many times, then you can just simply write a function and you can call that function whenever you want. So here I am calling that function. We can see the demo for this. Same function I have written. Def means we are defining some function. Function name is your own choice. I have written say hello. You can give whatever you want. So function, then colon. Inside it, I have given print hello world. And after that, I have used asterisk symbol, which is used to write your comment. So this block is belonging to this function I have written. After that, I didn't write any function. So this is obviously the end of the function. After that, I am calling that function, say hello. And we will run and we will see the output. So you are getting hello world as your output. Just we have defined one function and we have called that function. When we are calling this function, it will go here. Inside the function, it is written. So you will be getting the output of print hello world as your output. Then inside the function, you can pass the arguments. Again, one more function I have defined, which is print max. Yenga? Excuse me. If I have given print max, inside the function I have passed two arguments, a comma b. If a is greater than b, then print a is maximum. Else print b is maximum. Then I am calling that function with the arguments 3 comma 4. Get it. So this is an another function which we have created under the name of printmax. Inside it I have given the condition, if a is greater than b, it has to print a is maximum. Inside this you can pass any arguments. So this argument 3, you are calling this function printmax 3 comma 4. So this will be calling this function inside a comma, inside this function, this 3 and 4 will be passed. So you will be getting the output accordingly. Same program I have written here. Just the same. You see the output for this function. So 4 is maximum. Just I will save it and I will run it. Four is maximum according to the arguments passed in that function. You can call this function whenever you want. If you want 100 times the same function, but you want to pass with different arguments, then you can use the function like this. So first I have used 3 comma 4. Second, I am using 5 comma 7. If you want to pass some other argument also, you can pass it by changing the number. You see the output. So this function is used for used to call whenever you want to use that function multiple times. Next is built-in modules. So there are so many functions which has been used at the same time. So that will be used as the name with the modules. When multiple functions has been used together, then it will be called as modules. So here I have given an example. Import time. So time is one of the module which has been used here. Here print, I have given the sleep time is started. Next I have used that module time dot sleep of 3. So according to this, this will be used as a second in this module time. So this is a module, predefined module in Python, which is having more function in it. Then, using this module, I have written print the sleep is finished. So we are importing a module called time. Then this is a normal print statement. I have given the sleep time started. Inside that module, there is one function called sleep. After that, I have given one more print statement. The sleep is finished like that. You see the output of this program. Sleep time is started and sleep time is finished. We have given sleep time as 3 here. You can change it as a 10 also. So you can change it and you see the output, how long it is taking. So within 3 seconds, you have got the output in the last execution. Now you see the output. It will take 10 seconds. So to understand that, I have given 2 print statements in before time.sleep. I have given one print statement. After time.sleep, I have given another print statement. So inside this module, so many functions are there. Just I have given only one example. Like there, so many modules are also there. Then one more. We are importing OS. So os.list.dir home arulalan. If you are giving the list directory in this, then you will be getting the list of files from this directory. Same program I have copied, so I'm running that program directly. So you can see the output. So list of, this is with list of directories from user arulalan. So in this, these many files are there. This is with the extension of dot. These many files are there. So you can import OS and by using that module, you can use so many functions. Only I have given few functions here. This is the use of modules. So module is nothing but it's just a collection of functions which has been made like file or it is called a module. So we are directly importing that module. It is a built-in function in Python. So you can do your own modules. So here I am defining say hi as a one function. Inside that I am writing this is my module speaking. Just in print for understanding I am giving. You can give anything. After that I am assigning some value in the version. Then this is the end of the module. So here I have just copied that same program. I have defined one function. In that I have given something. Hi, this is my module speaking. Then version 1. First, I will run this and I will tell you it's just a. Just a function which you have written. So you will be getting this. Here we have just defined a function only. We didn't call this function. So it is just executed. There is no print function. There is no print statement. So you will not get any output here because I have just defined this function only. I didn't call this function. So you will not get output here. Only executed file. There is no print statement. Next. What? Listen, we have written one file or we have written one module. This module we are going to import. You can import your own module. For that only, first I have created our module. So I have created the module called mymodule.py file. Now we are going to import that file. So import my module, I am importing here. Then inside that mymodule.sayHi. So sayHi is a function. So I am calling it here. Then print version from this my module I am calling. Comma mymodule.version. Understand? We are just importing our own module which we have created before. And we are just calling that function from that module. So you got it? We are just importing that file. Then just I am calling that function. Then I am printing version from the mymodule.version. I am running and showing the output. It is 16th demo. So you can see you have got the output. Hi, this is my module speaking version 0.1. You have to note it very clearly. In the demo 16.py file, there is no print statement like this. Hi, this is my module speaking like that. I have run the demo 16 program. So there is no print statement. Print statement in the sense, there is no print statement like this. Hi, this is my module speaking. So how you are getting this output? You have imported your my module file. So from that you are getting output. We have imported it and we are accessing, means just we are calling that function. So you are getting the output. So you can create a own module like this and you can import your module into some other program as a module. This is important of creating own modules. So this is another example, my module demo 2.py. Here also we are just importing the same my module, but just we are not just directly importing from my module. We are just taking say hi like that. So here I have from my module import say hi and version. We are not totally just importing that module. Instead, we are from my module. We are just importing say hi function only. And version only. Then from my module import star. This is a command line, this and all command line. So next we are calling say hi, then we are giving print. This is the another method. You look here, then you will be understanding clearly. So these are all the comment. So from my module we are importing say hi only. Say hi is a function from my module. You see here. So it is a function and this is some variable. So from my module, we are just importing say hi function and version only. We didn't import the total module here. If you want, you can import like this also. You no need to import the total module. You can just import only the function, or you can just import only the variable from that module. So then I have imported this, then I am calling that function, then I am printing that. This is demo 17. Here also we don't create any print function using my module is speaking like that, but you will be getting the output because we are importing that function here. So you'll be getting the same output which we have just imported here. So this is this Python is object oriented programming language. I have told you in the introduction class itself, you can create classes, methods, inheritance, modules, etc. Since you people all belongs to scientific, so I'm not going deep in this. Okay, so I'm not going into object oriented programming language. Classes, method, inheritance, I am not going into deep. So next we are going for the file handling. So how to write a file and how to read a file using Python. It's very easy. So here an example I have given. I have taken one variable in the poem. Inside I have written something. Program is fun. When the work is done, if you wanna make your work also fun, use Python. So this is like some paragraph I have written. Using Python, you can just create a text file by using file function. So you can take any variable here. I have taken f equal to file of inside. I am just taking this variable dot txt file, comma, within single quotes, I have written w. This w is for writing a script. If you write w, this will be written into the file like poem.txt. Then f.write of poem, if you write, then it will write into a text file. Then you are just closing it by using f.close. So same example I have given here. I have written some paragraph. Then in the F, I have given just creating poem.txt file, comma W. Using F.write, I am writing this poem in this file. Then F.close, by using this, I am just finished writing. We are going to run this program, execute this program. So we have executed this, which means we have created the file under the name of poem.txt. First, I will show the list of files in this home folder. You can see there is a folder called poem.txt. This has been written using this program only, demo 18 file. Writing program only, this poem.txt has been written. Just now to make you more clear, I am just deleting this file and then again I am rerunning the program and I will show you. I am removing using the function rm. I am just deleting the file poem.txt file. I am just deleting it, so it is removing that file. Again, I am just showing the list of files. You can see it. There is no file called poem.txt. You can look into that. So again, I am running this program. Again, I am running. So I have run this program. Now this poem.txt file will be created because of this program. We can see the list now. So you can see it. Poem.txt file has been created now using this program. So poem.txt file has been created, which are having the script of this. So we will see this by using next program by reading the file. By using a Python program, you can read this file which we have created. So this is for writing. This is a program for writing. You can write anything like this. Next, we will write a program to read the file. So to read the file, first I am just writing f is equal to file of poem.txt, r. This is to read the file. I have just given inside the for loop for line in f dot read lines of function. So f dot read lines will read the lines from the file. So next I have given print line, then f dot close. After reading, it will get close. So we have just reading the file which we have created here. I am going to the function. I'm going to the example file read. Okay, now we will run this program. We are going to read this file and we will get the output of 18th program which you have written here. You will be getting it as an output because that is our task. We are going to read the file. You can see the output. Program is fun when the work is done. If you wanna make your work also fun, use Python. So using Python, we have read the file which has been written in the file of demo 18. That has been read by the program demo 19 by using f dot read lines. Then just you have imported the file which you have created, then by using for loop you have created. You can see the file which has been created, poem.txt here. So it has been created and it has been saved also. We didn't write this by opening and writing it. Just we have written it through the program only, and we have read that also through the program only using file writing and file reading using Python. So hope you enjoyed it. How to read the file, how to write the file, and what about the functions, what is the application of function, everything you might have understood. Now I am handovering to Mr. Arulalan. Thank you.
Okay. Hello, everyone. Hope you have learned a few things today. The continuation of the previous session, I'm going to cover something called a function we have already run. But I'm going to talk about the return statement in the function. Let me open previous example. See, this demo 12 program, what we have made is that we define a function using the keyword called def, and then our function name, print max. Then we made the arguments a comma b. Inside that, we have also written the statement like if a greater than b, then we are writing the if statement, a is maximum, else print b is maximum. So instead of that, what I'm going to I'll just copy it and make another function. So I'm making like a get max. So instead of printing a is maximum, what I'm doing, return a. Return B. So I'll just comment this using ashline. We can comment it in Python. So I'm just calling my function, whatever we wrote above. So we freshly made new function called getMax. We are passing two arguments, a comma b. If a is greater than b, then return return a, else return b. So let me check this, whether it's working or not. I didn't print it, so it is not showing anything. So now, after printing the return value, so it is showing as a 12. So what we are doing here, we are passing two arguments, so I say 10 and 12, and this 10 being assigned to A, 12 being assigned to B. Inside that, it is checking A is greater than B. So 10 greater than B, it's a false. So it will come to else statement, then it's just returning the B. B is 12. So that 12 return value being assigned to the my max. Then we can use the my max to do any operation, like here we are just printing it. If you want to write a more smart way, we can remove this also. Just else part I just removed. So if it is a greater than b, return a. Otherwise, as usual, it will come, because once the return statement is done, this will not be executed. This return b will not be executed. Only in the case of if condition if is over, so then it is returning B. Let me show you this also. So this also works 12. So you can write a single line function also, but I'm not showing it here. I don't want to confuse you people. So similarly for now I'm going to show you a few more examples in terms of using inbuilt modules, useful modules, few of them. There is some module called OS. So whatever the operations we are doing using OS, like creating files or creating directories, removing directories, what are the operations in available in the Unix command, that everything we can import inside Python and we can make use of it. Let me show you. So I just imported OS. OS dot, we can see so many functions. Also, okay, yeah, oh, it's fine. OS dot. There is a command called system. So it shows that it's command. What are the command you are executing in the Linux shell that you can execute here? Say, for example, I'm just doing ls. Sorry, it is not returning anything. That's OS dot system. Past 5 years I'm not using, so I'm not up to date. Let me check where I am. Okay, fine. Well, I understand. I've gone to yes, it's in bpython. It has gone to bpython. That's a different directory, so that there it was empty files. So in Python, in the current directory, we can see these many files are there. We are in the dev4 folder. There we can see these many files or folders, whatever it contains, it will be there. You can execute all the commands like ls and lrt. It just displaying how it used to display in the bash shell. If you want to make like a if you want to execute same command as how you are executing the shell, suppose make dir, you can create like make dir new folder we are going to create. So there is some more module called subprocess. You can use subprocess dot call that command. Whatever I just made as a string, that will be replaced here. Then this shell dot true is a argument, second argument, so it will treat it as a shell, and this command will wait till this command being executed and completed successfully. So it has been created and successfully. So now I'm just using os.system to print -ls -lrt. So you can see that the new folder being created just now, like a 1645 of 1st April. If you want to show in a GUI, I'll just show you this. This is day 4. So this new folder is just now created. If you have doubt, then I'll just remove it. We can do a remove function. You can use either a Python function itself, that os.remove function is there, remove directory is there, or if you want to use the system command itself, like a command rmdir new, then again I can execute it. See, that folder is gone. And this is the thing, this is very useful command, subprocess.call. Whatever the functions or whatever the command you are running in the system, that in a Linux system or an HPC, whatever the command you are running, everything can be imported here and you can run as it is. Like a CDO operations that also can be imported here. I'll show demo for that CDO. Not now, in upcoming classes, I'll show that. One more thing I would like to mention, I forgot that. In for loop, I'll just show some demo in terms of for loop. I can just create a new list called So I just created a new list like this. This containing zero, like a zero and zero, then one, and it's a multiply by two. 2, 2, 4, 3 and 6, 4, 8, 5, 10. So this is tuple we have seen already, and outside it's list. Suppose if we have already this kind of list, if you want to iterate it, you can use I comma j, or whatever the variable name you want to use it, you can use it, and then the list or the iteration there, print I and j, you can see that. So you can access like two elements or multiple elements together in a for loop. So I hope you people understand that study is inner for loop. If you have any doubt, then just write in that question session. So let us go to today class is end with this. Let us go to the doubt session. Because yesterday we didn't get enough time to clear few of the doubts. I'm just reloading it. Just come to the doubt session and write down your questions, either today's or yesterday's questions. Yeah, it has gone. It has come. It's day 4 and people are starting to write doubts. So you can see that till yesterday's presentation, day 1, day 2, day 3, the links are here. You can use it. Okay, then somebody has to how to know where the for loop ends. For loop ends is a back indentation. Let me come to some demo like yesterday's. Okay, this is yesterday's program. I mean, today's program. Suppose if I'm writing some statement here. So this is the end of the for loop. It's the same as other common block statement. Like how we used to understand if statement with the inner block. So these two lines are coming inside the for loop. And once it is back indentation with the same column of for, so this is the end. Before that, it is ending. Let me just execute this also. So this execution after the for loop. Then where and how I will get the listing of all available Python modules and the listing of all function within those modules. Listing of all Python modules, there are some way to get it using sys command. And somebody already mentioned the answer. You can go to this pypy.org, or you can go to document of python.org version 3 or version 2, whatever version you are comfortable. Or you can go to wiki.python.org useful modules. You can see it. And also they have answer like to get all functions of module. Yeah, this is the command I would like to show demo. We forget to mention earlier. Suppose we imported a module called OS. I don't know how many functions in available within this module called OS. So we can use the dir commands directory or dir. What are the objects available that you can post it? So these many functions or further modules are available within this OS command. So we see that we can create makedir, rmdir, listdir. We just now used that listdir. There are so many functions, direct functions available. This get cw gives what is the current directory, current working directory. Let me show you that get. So this shows the current working directory as a slash users or all and blah 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 until day 4 it is showing. You can use kill, using kill command you can kill any of the running process in your system. So again, within OS, there is yet another module called path. So if you are doing further os.path, then it is listing its own module, like os.path.join. Using this, we can find either it's a file or it's a directory. Likewise, you can get the all the inbuilt or available modules using dir. That's demo 16. Yeah, suppose we have already seen the demo 16. I'll just show you how this dir is works. We have seen this, just now seen this, how to use the my module. Suppose we have imported my module in day 16, demo 16. You can use this command called python-i, that's interactive, and then your script name. Once it is executed, this will launch into the Python shell. You can use the whatever. So I'm just using dir my module, and it is returning say hi and version. Only these two are available, and these are like, if it is starting from underscore underscore or ends with underscore underscore, these are all predefined functions or we can call it as a private files or private functions. So in general, if it is starting with without any underscore, then that's usable to the user. Those functions are usable to the user. Say hi and version. We already seen it here. It's our own module, my module. Say hi, it's a function, and version is a variable, so that can be accessed. So before accessing, we can see that what are all the stuffs available here. I tried to write the program, but I got error, like name error, name file is not defined. So I don't know why it shows, but you can use another option called of open. Let me show you where is it. Yes. Instead of file, you can use open also. So instead of file command, you can use open. Open command, again, instead of reading, you can use open command. Try this, and this also will work. So what is the difference between range and xrange function? Range and xrange, first of all, range is not available in Python 3. Let me show you example. Suppose a range, I'm giving some maximum number 10, so it is returned 10. Similarly, I can use the xrange also. But when I'm printing it a list, it is not printing the numbers. It's just written as a X range 10. This is called a generator. It is not a list. So what's the purpose of generating these numbers? Eventually we are going to use, mostly we'll be using the for loop. Suppose this range is being deprecated in Python 3. They removed it. I'll explain why they have removed it. Suppose if you're asking range 100, it will return 100 numbers. Okay. If you're asking 1000, 10,000, it will return. Say 10,000 numbers, it's just generated. If you're asking 1 lakh or 1 crore numbers, it will generate if your system is support. But eventually we are not going to use all of them at the same time. So what they have made using generator, also it will return, but whenever you are accessing through for loop, only that time it will return. So what I'm doing, I'm just accessing this X range. So if you're accessing through for loop or while loop or any other method, then that time it will return that next value. So it knows when to return. So at a time your RAM memory or your memory occupy only one integer or one number memory only. Instead of loading all 10,000 or 1 lakh numbers into the memory, it's just returning only one number. It will be loaded at a time in your memory. So this is called generator. We also can create our own generator. Instead of return statement, we have to use keyboard called yield. If you are using yield, then that will work. I'll just show you that. Yeah. Instead of return statement, we have to use yield. So this will return as a generator instead of normal function or instead of normal loop, normal list. So in Python 3, by default, the X range is there. You can use it. So this third question, we will put this program, whatever the program we are showing demo, that we'll host in the GitHub, and mostly by tomorrow or day after tomorrow we'll host it all together, and then we'll share it again below the YouTube links, YouTube videos, all the 5 videos or 10 videos underneath in the description. We'll paste this GitHub link of this whatever the demo we have taken. And here somebody mentioned will be useful if we have high level understanding of objects and class, which you mentioning as a few might coming directly from C language, where we don't have such a concept. Okay, if we want to, we have to take classes in objects, then we'll make schedule for a separate YouTube live stream. So only those who are interested to learn object oriented program, then we will take classes to them, because today we have more people, most of them scientists or PhD scholars. They may not need to go in deep into the object oriented programming concept. So we will announce once again, then that time you can join for the OOPS concept. Somebody asking some questions in chat. Okay, everybody came here. So again, it's 5 o'clock. So today we will end this today's session. Tomorrow we'll be showing about, we will discuss mostly about use of Python. And then I'll show the demo on how to write a program. I'll take some live task. Then within 5 to 10 minutes, we can write a script to complete that task. Mostly I'll be using all the functions we have shown you so far from the day 1 to day 4. I'll be using it, and then I'll show you demo. Also, I'll discuss about how to contribute to the Python program. And finally asking, yes, tomorrow I'll show you that how to read and write CSV files. Using that, we will write a program. I have made some tasks. Those who were registered for this session, Python session, everybody might have registered in the Google form. So that I have a Google Forms response. I'll be downloading that form into CSV file. Then I'll read that CSV file through program, Python program. Then we can do some operation, how many people are registered, belongs to some organization. We can get the counts. Then again, that also we can write into some CSV file. Hope you enjoyed today. Again, we'll meet tomorrow 4 p.m. Thank you.
Thank you to Lindor presenting.